There are many other applications like constructing the expression tree. From the post order expression. Okay. I'll leave you with an idea as to how to go about it. Suppose I have a, b, c plus n star. Okay. What we do is, when we have symbols, first we have again a forest of trees pointing to A. This pointing to B, this point as you traverse from the left to right of this expression. As you move from left to right of this expression, what do? You just create pointers to trees in a forest. Then what you do is you come across plus, then you create a new node with plus, and then you take the topmost two, it is like a stack, okay. This is actually like a stack, then you, this is actually a stack of trees. What we do is, now I put these from left to right, I put the trees A, B and C, and then as soon as I come across the operator, what do? I pop the most recent two trees, then I create a new tree with a plus and I make the first tree the left child, the most recently popped out tree the left child, and the previously popped out tree the right child. Now again I have one more symbol left, I come across the star, so I pop out both these trees and I create, put onto the stack the star and the two pop trees become the most recently popped tree becomes the right child, and the previously the most recently popped tree becomes the left child, and the previously popped tree becomes the right child. Okay, and as soon as until you get a single tree which exists on the stack. So there is another application of binary trees and stacks. Both of them can be used quite efficiently to build what are called expression trees. Okay. So this is a very, very useful application of binary trees. Now the another thing that we always like to do when we build binary trees, let us take this expression tree itself. Let us look at an expression . Let's say we have something like this. Then what are we doing? When an expression is evaluated, it's evaluated from the left. So let's say I have this over here plus star B C. Actually, you go over this from the right, and let me. Let us say I form an expression tree. I don't know how many of you are familiar. We use this kind of a expression parsing to do this. Expression term or expression. And term is factor, and let us say factor is a name as in this example. What is name? Let us say it is A, B, so on over here. Okay. Suppose I use this grammar to generate this expression. You would have already done a course on compilers. Let us see, this is completely an unambiguous grammar. The add up here is plus or minus, mult op is star or slash. Let us see. So, how do we parse this given expression? So, start from the root over here. Expression is defined as expression add operator term. So, I stop it, start it over here. Okay. Plus, then what do we have? Then on the left hand side, another plus, again at the plus. Then I will get A here, I will get star B C. And star D plus E F. Okay. This is how you will get a binary tree. What have I done now? All this exercise that I have done is to just show that an expression, a harmless expression that is written like this, can be written as a binary tree. Now, what we will do is we will talk about other things now. We will talk about traversal of these trees, of this tree. Let us see what it gives us. There are three types of traversals: pre-order, post-order and in-order. Okay. All right. Now, the definitions are given over here, how to traverse these trees. So, pre-order traversal says visit the root, then what do? You visit the left child in pre-order recursively, visit the right child in pre-order recursively. Means what now? Let us take the, then the in-order traversal says visit the left child in in-order recursively, visit the root, visit the right child in in-order recursively. Okay. Then post order traversal says visit the left child in post order and visit the right child in post order recursively, visit the root. Okay. All right, let us see what this gives. So, everything has to be done recursively. What is the meaning of this? Okay, let us look at in order traversal. Visit the left child in order recursively. Let us say I want to do this traversal of the tree. Okay. Traversal means simply walking around the tree. Okay. Just the way they list the nodes is what changes. Now, what does it say? Let us look at in order traversal. It says first we look at in order because it will become clear to you what we are doing. Visit left child recursively, visit root and visit right child recursively is what your in order traversal is. So, let us look at this tree, what would we do? So, that means I am starting from the root here and I am going to recursively keep on going down to this until I reach the leaf node. Then what do? I display the leaf node. So, I keep going down because I have to visit the leftmost children. Then what happens? I go up. Okay. Then I visit the root. I get plus. Then again I go to the right child and again I have to recursively do the same thing. That means what? Pre-order, in-order, all these are recursive traversals. Okay. So, I go to the right child, then again I will do left child recursively, root, then right child and then go back up. Then what happens here? So, I come down this plus, go down here, this becomes B star C. Okay. And then what happens? This node has already been visited. So, I go back up to the root of the tree, give me plus, then again I come to the right node star again I have to do recursively left child, right. So, I do D, I come to the leaf node, star, then I have to have E plus F. The bracket has to come because it is one level lower. So, in order traversal essentially gives me the expression back. So, what does it tell me now? When I look at the in order traversal of the tree, I get the infix expression of the given tree, okay. There is one extra information that we have used here. We use the fact that star is done after plus because it is one level lower in the tree, okay. So, I get the infix expression. So, let us look at what post order expression, post order traversal of the tree will give you. What does post order traversal say? Post order traversal says visit left child post order in post order recursively, then visit right child in post order recursively, visit root, and the same thing keeps on getting repeated again and again. So, I take the left child recursively, visit in post order. Let me just explain this over here. Let us see what this will give us. What does it give you? So, I visit the left child. I came down, there are no more leaf nodes. So, I display A. Then I have to go to the right child. Go back, right. Left child, right child, and then root is what it says. Go to the right child. Then right child, again I have to recursively go down, do post order, right. Left child, right child, then root. So, what will happen? I get A, B, C star, then what do I get? Now, all of them have been visited. I go back up. So, left child, right child, then root, get plus here, and then what happens? So, the left child of this root tree is completed now. So, I go to the right tree over here. Then what do I get now? What do I get here now? I get D, then again this is the left child, this is the leaf node, there is nothing else to see, therefore, I display the leaf node. Then I go to its right child, again I have to look at post order over there, therefore, I get EF plus, because E left child post order, right child post order, root, okay. Then I will put the plus over here, that is how it comes here, and then finally the star, and then finally the plus, the last plus sign that we have. Sorry, I made a mistake here, this plus should not be here, yeah. See A, B, C star, then I have to do the right child, D, F plus star plus, okay. So, what did we get now? We have got A, B, C star, oh, plus correct, D, E, F correct, sorry, plus is there, correct, D, E, F plus star plus. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, correct, okay. So, this is what we get as the expression. What is this expression now? This is nothing but the postfix expression which all of us have already been done, okay. When we talked about stacks, we talked about generating a postfix expression from an infix expression. So, what is interesting here is once it is represented as a binary tree, if I do in order traversal, I get the infix expression. When I do post order traversal, I get the postfix expression. And obviously, if I do pre order traversal, I will get the prefix expression, okay. So, this is also a very big application of binary trees. Now, once this expression is given like this, I can use this stack of trees to evaluate this particular expression. So, I hope you are with me here and you have understood what I have said. So, what is it that we are doing? Notice that another way of looking at these various traversals to make it simpler is pre-order traversal can be thought of as you display the node the first time you visit it, okay. In in-order traversal, you display the node the second time you visit it. Remember this, I have drawn this path over here which goes around the tree, and in post-order traversal, you display the node the last time you visited, okay. So, these are simple traversal schemes, okay. So, now the next question that we would like to ask is, suppose you are given only the traversals. Traversals are given, can we construct the tree? Exactly. Okay. Let's look at only with respect to binary trees and see if I am given the, what is it that we have two traversals now, in-order traversal and we have the post-order traversal. We can also do the pre-order. I encourage you to do the pre-order traversal of the tree. Now, given the in-order traversal, can I construct the tree uniquely without any other information? And given the post-order traversal, can I construct the tree uniquely? Let's see how we will do this in the next lecture.